So after understanding residential status, let us revise whatever we have discussed, and we are about to conclude this chapter, but we will conclude it tomorrow, not today. Okay. So what I have taught you, what I started teaching you in this particular chapter was a charging section. Actually, from day one till now, we are studying only one section, and that is section 4. So many things were connected to section 4 because I told you section 4 is the backbone of income tax. Okay. Without understanding section 4, if you try to read law, then there is no purpose of understanding this income tax. And this is what your section 4 talks about. Okay. It's a revision of whatever you have done up till now. Section 4 is the charging section, okay, of income tax, section 4, which says total income. Yes or no? Yes. The first word was total income. Total income I taught you in section 5. Hello? Yes. Scope of total income. How did we understood that particular section? So total income you divided into two parts. Indian income, foreign income. Indian income you divided into further four parts. Income accrues in India, income received in India, income deemed to be received in India, and income deemed to be accrued in India. Am I clear? Yes. Accrued in India means source of income is located in India. Received in India means first place of receipt is located in India. Hello?
Yes.
Alright. Then deemed to be received in India and deemed to be accrued in India, we haven't discussed in detail because that is written in section 7 and section 9, which had to be addressed. Okay. And then there is the foreign income. Foreign income is income which is not accrued in India, not received in India. That means it is accrued outside India, received outside India. It is divided into two parts for our taxation purpose. One is business control from India. Although it is located in foreign, but it is business control from India. On Indian income, on this foreign income, OR, NOR and NR will pay tax. On this income, second type of income, foreign income but control from India, OR and NOR will pay tax, and other foreign income, only OR will pay tax because of residence rule, which is possessive rule. Alright, that's what we have discussed in total income under section 5. Person, hello, person, person definition what we have discussed in section 2, clause 31. Individual, HUF, AOP, BOI, firm, LLP, company, local authority, artificial juridical person. So, itne type ke person hote hain. Person becomes assessee. Definition of assessee is not defined, but person in future will become assessee. A resident assessee and non-resident assessee. So, we have discussed residential status under section 6. Hello? Section 5 and section 6. Then we have discussed what is previous year. Hello? I told you previous year has to end on 31st March. That is for sure. It may or may not start at April, but it has to end on
31st March.
And this is the financial year immediately preceding to assessment year. Previous year is the financial year immediately preceding to assessment year. Then what was the assessment year, sir? Assessment year means a period of 12 months commencing on 1st April every year. So every 1st April, now coming 1st April is the new assessment year. Okay, that is your assessment year which is about to start. Okay, so that is previous year and assessment year. For you previous year is 1819, for you assessment year is 1920. While writing exam you will be in 1920. Hello? Yeah? So this course is that updated. See, you did not reach there. This year has even not started, but we are teaching you for 1920. Alright, you go to become, they are teaching you for 1415 or 1516. This is the difference, you understand, between professional courses. This is proactive course. We teach things that about to happen, not what has happened, which is about to happen. It's that relevant, okay? Then assess, okay? This word today I'm going to teach. Assess means what, sir? Assess means this. Assess is equal to computation of tax. Assess. Hum bolte na, are, can you assess my marks? Can you assess this? That means assess means compute. What are we computing in income tax? Obviously, we are computing tax on income. We are computing tax on income. So, to compute tax, you need to have two factors. Tax is a product of two elements. Please understand. The first element is tax base and second element is tax rate. You have to apply tax rate on tax base. Tax rate on tax base, and tax base is the total income in income tax. My charge is on total income. If I say 10% is tax rate or 30% is the tax rate, the 30% you will apply on total income. Now total income can be divided into two parts again, okay? Special income and normal income. Salary is a normal income, rent is a normal income, business is a normal income, but lottery, special income, capital gain, special income. You understand? So there are two types of incomes we have, normal income and special income, and according to that we take tax rates. Okay, for normal income you take normal tax rates, for special income you take special tax rate. Are we clear about this much? This is my charging section. By connecting charging section, allow me to continue my discussion so far as tax rates in India are concerned. Okay, these are the tax rate that we have. This is one of the common question that we usually ask to our articles. Alright, this is concept, na? Okay, this is a very common question that we ask to our articles, that GST rates are given in GST Act. Okay, so income tax rates are given in which act? The obvious answer comes, obviously income tax rate should be given in Income Tax Act, but the reality is that income tax rates are not given in Income Tax Act. If somebody is asking you question that would interview, answer of which is very much obvious, then do not give that answer if you don't know the answer. You understand? Do not guess and give it. Don't guess. If you know it, then only answer. If you don't know, then simple say, sir, I don't know exactly, I'm not sure about it. But I believe, I guess it should be there in income tax. At least you should. You're very confident, Income Tax Act. Then that confidence shows that even if you don't know the answer, but still Mumbai University have trained you to show the confidence. Alright? If there is an answer like this, then you will write. If there is no answer, then you will create. Mumbai University train you for that, okay? If that concept exists, very good. It doesn't exist, we will create. You write anything and everything which comes to your mind in exam. Alright, don't do that in professional courses. Professional courses are not about quantity. It's about the quality. Alright, what quality you write? And the basic quality in law's paper, any law paper, tax is the law. You need to write answer only if you know the section. If you don't know the section, don't write the answer. Write something else. But don't write answer for the question. According to me, this assessor should be raised in. According to you, section mein kya likha hai, wo bata. Nahin, I feel, I believe, ye language, nahi, either, nahi. As per section 6, subsection 1, this assessor is the resident assessor. It has to be that precise. Nobody is asking you for your background, assessor's background, or a story behind it. No, just section, law. Section, law. Am I clear? Yeah. So, sir, what is the right answer if someone asks me where tax rates are given? So, dumb people say the Income Tax Act. Okay. Smart people say Annual Finance Act. Okay. And super intelligent people who actually have studied Income Tax Act, they give proper, appropriate answer. An appropriate answer is, if it is normal income, sir, if it is ordinary income, then rates are given in Annual Finance Act. And if it is a special income, then rates are given in Income Tax Act itself. So to compute tax, we borrow tax rates from two different acts, from Annual Finance Act for normal income and for Income Tax Act for special income. Am I clear? Alright. Sir, what if I don't have special income? Then you will not travel to Income Tax Act. Your assessment will be done in Finance Act itself. So there are two types of tax rate: normal tax rate, special tax rate. Normal tax rate on normal income, special tax rates on special income. So what are the special income we have in income tax? That is given in 110 to 115. Our responsibility is not to understand those special income. Those are given in their chapter, respective chapter. So capital gain you will understand only in capital gain chapter. But from today we have to start writing about it, start listening about it, and therefore we are initiating discussion of future few chapters now. Alright, so tax rates you are learning today. Tomorrow morning you are going to understand how to compute tax. Actually, computation of tax is the last stage. Income tax we read to compute tax. Tomorrow only I am going to teach you how to compute tax, because computation of tax is not difficult. What is difficult in income tax is to compute right amount of income. Hello? Balance 100 hours we are going to invest in how to compute income. That's all. Hello? You are getting my point. How to compute tax? You give me 2-3 hours, I will teach you how to compute tax. To compute tax, you will be provided income. You just have to apply these rates on tax. That's all. You will get the tax amount. Yes or no? Alright. So, sir, these two things you need to write in reading: Annual Finance Act and Income Tax Act. When I say Annual Finance Act, some people don't get it clearly. What is Annual Finance Act? So in India, Annual Finance Act is known as a budget. Alright, usually we people call budget. Budget 18, budget 17, budget 19 is about to pronounce by central government. Yes or no? In first week it will come. Okay, you please watch TV channel on that day and buy in Economic Times immediately on next day. I will show you these rates in actual Finance Act. Economic Times is a newspaper which prints whole Finance Act schedule. This schedule. Okay. I will show you for next year. That is not applicable for our exam. But I cannot ask you to buy paper on 1st paper 2018. So at least buy now. So I will show you how it you have to see it. Okay. How you have to read it. So that whenever in rest of your life. Because now you are connected to these things. This is not for exam. This is for whole life from now. Every budget now onwards you are going to read. Whether it is for exam or professional life, but you are going to read budget every year. Yes or no?
Yes.
Alright. And therefore, you must understand how to read budget. Whether I am in Mumbai or not, immediately the next day after budget, okay, you need to buy one newspaper and keep it safe. You may not understand. You will understand. I don't know. When I come back, I will explain you how they have created that particular table. Okay. Where to find this particular thing in Annual Finance Act. Actually, here module is there, so module has done the thing, module has copied it from Annual Finance Act and given it as a ready-made material. But in practical word, we need to understand it, okay? So these two things you will write in reading. So which budget is applicable to you? Budget 19 which has not come yet or budget 18? Budget 18, obviously, budget 18 is applicable for financial year 18-19. Hello, budget 18 came in Feb 18. Budget means bill comes, okay, finance bill. Finance minister doesn't have power to make finance act. He has power to make finance bill. Bill will be presented in a Lok Sabha, then a Rajya Sabha, and then president will sign it. Hello. Then that bill will become finance act, okay. And it takes one month, 1.5 months. Therefore, they launch budget, this bill, in the month of Feb. So Feb, they full month they fight in parliament. You know how they talk and how they discuss these bills. So Feb they will fight, March they will fight, and we expect from 1st April this budget will become applicable. So this budget which is applicable to us was declared on 1st Feb and it was become applicable on 1st April 2018, which was your first day of previous year. And it will be applicable till 31st March 2019. If before that, please understand, very technical terms I am teaching you. If before 31st March 2019, budget 19 will come? Yes or no? Now budget 19 may be approved, may not be approved. If they wanted to approve, opposition wanted to approve, they will approve. They may stop the budget. And if 2019 starts, next financial year start, and this budget 19 is yet to approve, so it's just a bill. So which finance act should I follow in that April, sir? This question may come. So we say whichever is more beneficial to SEC has to take call, because both laws are existing, last law and current law, and current law is not yet amended. Alright, so it is in bill form and last law is in act form. So which one I should follow, 19 bill or 18 act? No, whichever is more beneficial. We also say 18 act, this is by default answer. But the reality that SEC is allowed to follow whichever is more beneficial. Okay? Yes. Sir, where is it written? In your modules. I got this information in your module, your institute book. Okay? So you just have to have patience and read it. Everything is written somewhere. Okay? So is it in syllabus? Will they ask in exam? See beta, your CMA institute was not created to conduct exam. Your institute was created to make you professionals. We don't know what is going to be there in exam or not. What is going to be applicable in life? Yes, we know. Whatever is happening in economy, we know. And this is what is happening in economy, and you should be get prepared for that, not for only examination. Okay? Wo BCom wagera mein chalta hai. So passing mark aa gaya, bas ho gaya na. Bas ho gaya. Then after that, tomorrow you will become finance manager of a company. Then, nahi sir, wo syllabus mein option mein dala tha maine. PGBP was an option. I don't know how to compute it. Chalega? Nahi ra. You understand? So, Finance Act 2018 and Income Tax Act 1961. Allow me to explain this few rates first. These are These are special rates of tax which are given in respective chapter. STCG means short term capital gain. STT paid, in bracket what is written in, it has to be written, when you write it, you should write it in reading, this bracket, okay? This is not normal short term capital gain. This is share market short term capital gain. Sir, how do I come to know about share market capital gain? Because they have written STT paid. STT means security transaction tax. Whenever you trade in share market, you have to pay security transaction tax. If you have paid that tax, then already you have paid one tax. In India, on an average, our tax rate is 30%. So we need to give you concessional rate of tax, and therefore they have created 111A, section 111A, where tax rate is only 15%. Okay, this is one thing. Second, normal long-term capital gain. If you have sold land, building, gold, debentures, something like this, okay, then your tax rate is 20% in India. Long-term capital gain, LTCG. Okay, 112, section 112. Long-term capital gain on share market. Long-term capital gain on share market. Section 112A, new section. Abhi aaya, 2018 mein. All right. If that share market gain is more than 1 lakh, it's more than?
1 lakh.
Then you will have 10%. Last year, my gain was around 8 or 9,000. Will I pay tax under 112A? No, because I'm exempt. So government is not taking tax from person like me. Government is trying to tax people who are earning very good amount of income in share market. Hello. If it is more than 1 lakh, then only it is taxable, and that too taxable at only 10%. That is 112A. New section has been inserted. Okay. Can I go ahead? Yeah. Casual incomes. Casual income. Please understand. Casual income means income where you haven't put much efforts. So on mobile, you were playing some card games. Teen Patti or something that you play, I don't know. Alright. And you won the game. And that game authority has given you 10,000 rupees. That is casual income. You played that Dream 11.
Yeah.
Alright. You set up one team. You won that team. You got 1 lakh rupees out of it. Taxable at 30%. You took one Diwali bumper offer lottery. Alright. You scratch that lottery. You won the first prize, 50 lakh rupees. Good. Along with you, one more person is happy. Government. Because they are going to get 30% without taking the lottery. And you will also not mind paying 30% because you suddenly got 15 lakh rupees. Out of 50 lakh rupees, you can pay 15 lakh rupees as a tax. Hello, if you get 1 crore tomorrow in government saying that give us 30 lakh, you will not mind. Okay, khush rahe, tu bhi kya yaad karega? Because out of 1 crore, you are just paying 30 lakh. Still 70 lakh is with you. In kon banega crorepati if you have observed, when person reach to that level, 10 lakh level and all, so Amitabh Bachchan will sign one check. Then he will give that guy. Then they will take photograph. Have you ever seen that check has been handed over to him? No. Amitabh Bachchan takes back that check and keep it here, because that check is fake check. That is not actual check. Because Amitabh Bachchan cannot give that much amount to guy. Hello. It's not possible because there is a tax rate. How much? 30%. Okay. Horse races, dating, gambling. तुम अगर ऐसा कुछ करते हो तो तुम बाजीगर हो, और वो भी बड़े बाजीगर हो, क्योंकि तुम सोरठ थोड़ी ना क्या निकाले हो, वो स्क्रैच एंड विन भी कर सकते थे ना. यू आर पुटिंग मनी ऑन हॉर्स रेसिंग, इंडिया पाकिस्तान मैच बेटिंग. हेलो, तो यू आर बाजीगर. ऑलराइट, यू कैन पे 30% टैक्स. तुम्हारा दिल बहुत बड़ा होता है. ऑलराइट, सो 30% ऐसा है. इफ अजय देवगन कम्स टू योर हाउस विद दैट रेड टीम, and if they find black money, do you think that they are going to take 5%, 10% like this rate? No, simple 60%. They don't take much, only 60%. Then 25% surcharge, and then 4% cess. So technically it becomes 78%. That happens under section 115BBE. That we will talk. There is a chapter called aggregation of income in our syllabus. Okay, it's a two-page chapter, but there is a chapter, dedicated chapter. But what is the tax rate of black money? If government finds black money with you, what is the tax rate? 60%, 60 is the base rate. Actual rate is 78%, but base rate is? Which is quite high, yes or no? Then you should not earn black money. Earn in white. Hello? Alright. Dividend. So far as dividend is concerned, let me tell you one thing. Dividend in India is exempt. Last year I got dividend around 112 from one company. Some 300, 400 rupee dividend total. Okay. Will it be taxable? 300 rupee. Do you think the government is worried about my 300 rupee dividend that I earn in a year? Hello. government is saying that dividend from Indian company is exempt, but only up to 10 lakh. Now 10 lakh is very big number for your knowledge. To earn dividend of 10 lakh rupees in share market, you must have your holding more than 100 crores. Then only you will get dividend up to 10 lakh. Because dividends are not given on market price, dividends are given on face value. Okay, and face value of some shares are having face value 10, but market value 70,000, 80,000. Hello, this is the gap because market prices are too high. So to become shareholder, you have to pay 70,000, say for example, then you will get one share. And tomorrow company will declare 20% dividend. 20% of not 70,000, 20% of face value. That means 2 rupiah milega tumko, 2 rupiah. You understand? Do bar susu karne ja sakte ho. Only 2 rupees. Will it be taxable? Hello?
No.
Why? Because it is up to 10 lakh, sir. Government is not interested in that. But there are classes in India. Classes means persons classes. Alright. In that class, they have investment in market, 1000 crore, 500 crore, okay, 10,000 crore, Ambani's, Adani's, Tata's, Birla's, Mahindra, hello, all these families, they own crores of rupees in share market, they get dividend also in crores. Government asking, tum log itna ameer hai yaar, kitna ameer yaar, itna ameer ho, 10% bhar do na yaar. Kya farak padta hai, tumhare 100 crore mein se humne 10 crore le liya, kya farak padta hai? 90 crore to abhi bhi aap hi ke paas hai. Alright, so this is how government is treating them. Dividend above 10 lakh is taxable. I personally call this section 115 babda. 115 babda. BBD. The name is BBD. 115 babda. Okay, rate kitna hai? Wo yaad rakhna hai. Babda nahi. Rate kitna hai? 10%. Okay. Do you want to encourage innovation in India or discourage innovation in India? Encourage. If you encourage innovation, then people will submit their IPRs. People will get IPR, intellectual property rights. And then they will give that IPR to companies and authors and some other people, all right? And then they'll start earning royalty income, okay? On an average in India, we pay 30% tax rate. Royalty being a pure income, you want people to earn this income. And government wanted to encourage by levying minimum amount of taxes. Therefore, government is applying only 10% rate. Government saying, we will not take 30% from you. You are Indian patentee. You are such an intelligent person. You do more work. You pay only 10% tax on whatever royalty you earn. Even if it is in crores, you just pay 10%. Am I clear? So these are the special rates of tax. Are we clear about this area? Let me finish normal area also. Okay? कोई doubt नहीं होना चाहिए यहाँ पे? क्योंकि मैंने कुछ पढ़ाया नहीं. आई जस्ट टोल्ड यू देर आर दिस टाइप ऑफ सेक्शंस, उसमें ऐसे रेट है. सर पढ़ाओगे कब? व्हेन चैप्टर कम्स. अलाउ मी टू रीच टू दैट चैप्टर. आज क्या पढ़ना है? ये. ओके, एग्जाम में क्या आएगा? इंडिविजुअल. बाकी क्यों पढ़ा रहे हो? एमसीक्यू. देर आर मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन, सो एनीथिंग कैन कम फ्रॉम दिस एरिया इन मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन. All right, so individual, annual finance act, सबसे पहले समझो, this is on normal income, okay? Individual का क्या है इंडिया में? Slab rate. Individual का क्या चलता है? Slab rate. Sir, slab rate means what? तो you will change your personality as per level of income. So up to 2.5 lakh, you are गरीब people, okay? From 2.5 lakh to 3.5 lakh, you are still गरीब, बस taxpayer गरीब. Up to 2.5 lakh, you don't pay tax. So you can call yourself BPL, below poverty line, okay? 2.5 lakh to 3.5 lakh. You are liable to pay tax, but you will not pay tax full amount. You will ask for rebate. There is a rebate, no? 87, you remember? Rebate, you will demand rebate. 3.5 lakh to 5 lakh, or actually 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, the tax rate is 5%. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh tax rate is 5%. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh tax rate is 5%, but subject to rebate. There is a rebate in this class. Okay, sir, I am earning in more than 5 lakh. Then good, congratulations. Now you need to pay tax at the rate of 20% on that income above 5 lakh and up to 10 lakh. So if you are earning 7 lakh income, how will it tax? Up to 2.5 lakh, nil. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh. This is a slab, na? Up to 2.5 lakh, nil. Iske upar tax nahi. Isko hata do. Itne paise ka hata do. Okay, balance jo bacha. Alright, 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh. Only 5%. So 2.5 lakh ka 5%. 12,500. Okay, above that kitna? 5 lakh ke upar kitna kama raha hai? 2 lakh. 2 lakh का 20%, that is 40,000. तो total कितना हो गया? This 40,000 plus this 12,500 plus zero, 52,500. Something like this we do. We will do that in lot of calculations. But this is how slab operates. Hello, okay, sir. So individual is in slab rate. Okay, this is a slab. I will show you. Up to 2.5 lakh, nil. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%. 5 lakh to 10 lakh, 20%. And above 10 lakh, 30%. That is not there, I will write. Above 10 lakh, 30%. 2.5 lakh, nil. 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh, 5%. 5 lakh to 10 lakh, 20%. Above 10 lakh, 30%. This is basic income tax rates. Agar tera dadaji hai, abhi bhi. And if he is 65 year old and is still working somewhere and earning his own bread and butter, will you feel proud about him?
Yes.
Yes, government also feel proud about him because he is not dependent on his own production. That is your father. Alright. He doesn't want that they should look after me. Why? He can look after himself. He just have to work somewhere. That's all. And anyhow, what will they do at home? So they are working. So that is the productivity. They are happy to work. It's not that they are working because of money, but they are working for their daily life and they are earning money also. Good, very good. Congratulations. You are not burden on your own family and you are not burden on nation also. And you are a Buddha and you are a productive Buddha. And government appreciate productive Buddha by giving him higher slab and salute. Okay. So the productive Buddha will get benefit up to 3 lakh. Up to 3 lakh. Usually we get benefit up to 2.5 lakh. No tax up to 2.5 lakh. But if you are a Buddha, that is 60 year plus, then you will get benefit up to 3 lakh. But this benefit is given only to domestic Buddha, not to foreign Buddha. Because our government is not worried about foreign Buddhas. Come on, yaar, thank God our government is worried about at least domestic Buddhas. Alright. So this resident world is more important. In exam it comes. Non-resident SSC 68 year old. What is the slab rate? 2.5. What if SSC is the resident? 3 lakh. Because for resident it is 3 lakh and for non-resident it is 2.5 lakh only. Okay, this higher benefit, higher exemption, higher basic exemption is given to resident Buddha. Okay. Pakka. Sir, senior citizen bolo na. Nahi, mujhe Buddha achha lagta hai. Sir, exam mein likhe kya Buddha? Nahi. Exam mein you should write senior citizen. Respect. Buddha kya? Buddha. Tum log wo sab nahi. Apne local language mein. Okay. Sir, I have great grandfather also. Very good. Sir, he is 87 year old. Amazing. Sir, he's still working. Wow. Wow, literally wow. Sir, he is earning but not working. He has created sufficient investment and those investments are paying him now. Hello. Alright, amazing, yaar, amazing. We should truly respect these people. Alright. And therefore government says, Namaskaram, up to 5 lakh. Hello. You people are resident super Buddhas. Okay. Super senior citizen. Citizen world is missing here. Resident super senior citizen. Kitne year ke baad?
80 years.
Tumhara 5 lakh tak no tax. Tum paisa kamao. Puri life tumne tax bhara. Ab tum paisa kama. Alright, up to 5 lakh, no tax. Enjoy. Sir, what if Buddha is earning and super Buddha is earning after 5 lakh? After 5 lakh, everybody is paying 20%. After 10 lakh, everybody is paying 30%. So there is no discrimination in 20% slab. There is no discrimination in 30% slab. There is only discrimination in 5% slab. Some people pay tax up to 2.5, nobody pay tax. Ordinarily, we pay tax from 2.5 lakh to 5 lakh at 5%. Buddha people pay 3 lakh to 5 lakh at 5%. And super Buddha doesn't pay 5%, directly 20% and then 30%.
Yes.
Will you keep it in mind?
Yes.
Very important thing that this higher benefit is given only to resident. It is not given to non-resident. Are we clear about this? This is known as slab rate. Okay. And this is known as base slab rate, basic slab rate. This is basic. This is applicable to many people. Individual, HUF. This is individual. Huh? This is individual, not joint. Individual, HUF, AOP, BOI, AGP. So this is applicable.